All right, this is fifth grade, module 5, lesson 15, and in this lesson, students are going to be solving real-world problems, word problems, again, finding the area of rectangles involving multiplication of mixed numbers. Now, what's different about this lesson compared to lesson 14 is that these problems are just a little bit bigger, a little more complicated. So parents and teachers, you may want to consider thinking of new ways of doing this rather than just a traditional homework assignment where students are solving them all by themselves, because that may foster really feelings of inadequacy and like, geez, this is hard, I hate math, and blah, 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 blah. So consider getting creative and doing this as a jigsaw, assigning a group to solve a problem and let them work together and collaboratively and then share with the rest of the class. Or consider doing one problem at a time, maybe per night. Just something so that we don't use math to beat up our students. So let's get started on this.
All right, so the width of a picnic table is 3 times its length. So I'm going to underline that. If the length is 5/6 yard long, what is the area of the picnic table in square feet? Now here's the key thing. This says square feet, but our clue is in yards. So that's going to be a tricky thing. So that's going to be neat, actually. So let's get going on this. So first thing we're going to do is we're going to draw the picture. We're going to represent this with a picture. So if the length is 5/6 yards, and the width is 3 times its length. So what is that going to look like? Well, the length is going to look like this, and that is 5/6 of a yard. And then the width is three times that length. So basically, it's going to be 5/6 plus 5/6 plus 5/6, all right? And so that is what the picnic table is going to look like right there. 5/6, and this is 3 times 5/6. So what is the area of the picnic table in square feet? So that's the first key thing is we can see that this width is going to be 15/6. Now, how do we know it's going to be 15/6 of a yard? Well, that's because if this guy is 5/6, and this is 3 times that, so that's going to be 5/6 plus 5/6 plus 5/6, or 3 times 5, so 15/6, all right? So the first thing we have to do is we need to convert each of these lengths into feet, because we want to know square feet, not square yards. And so first thing we've got to do is we're going to take that 5/6, and we're going to take that 5/6 of a yard, and we want to turn it into how many feet? So that's going to be 5/6 yards is equal to 5/6 times 3 feet, because a yard is equal to 3 feet. And then 5/6 times 3 feet is going to be 15/6 feet. And then, so this is really 15/6 feet. And then in the same way, we've got to multiply 15/6 yard, and that's kind of an unfortunate thing that it has the same number, 15/6. But we're going to take that 15/6 yard, and we want to turn it into feet. So that's going to be 15/6 times 3 feet, which equals 45/6 feet. And that makes sense because 3 times 15 is 45. So we're going to cross off this one in yards, and we're going to replace it with 45/6 feet. So we took the yards, converted it into feet. We took the yards, converted it into feet. And now we want to find the area. So what are we going to do to find the area? We are simply going to, I don't know if it's simple, but we are going to multiply 15/6 by 45/6. and get our answer. You're going to have to do some converting your improper fraction into a mixed number, but pretty much you just multiply 15 times 45, 6 times 6, you get 36, and then you're going to do some division to turn that number into a mixed number. And that's your process. I'm not going to actually do all the work for you on this one. I'm just going to map out that strategy. I think the key thing is converting these yards into feet. Here, a painting company will paint this wall. The owner gives them a variety of things. You've got these windows and you've got a door. You've got the entire wall itself. What is the area of the painted space? Well, we know that we're going to have to multiply 52.5 times 33. That's going to give us the entire wall. And then we know we're going to have to multiply 6.25 times 5.75. That's going to give us window A. And then we're going to have to do 3 1/8 times 4. That's going to give us window B. And then we're going to have to do window C. Now, notice window C, they already give us the answer. They say it's the answer. The area is 9.5 feet squared. So that means 9.5 is window C. So we don't have to multiply like we do for A and B. And then D, the door is pretty easy, 4 times 8. 4 times 8, and that's going to give us D. All right. So now what's our strategy? Well, we're going to multiply all of these, get all of these answers, although there is no multiplication on C. And then we're going to take these four answers, add them together, and subtract from the wall. So we're going to take the answer for the wall, and we're going to subtract our answer when we add up A, B, C, and D. And when we do that, that is our answer. So there's a lot of work, but the strategy is pretty straightforward. Get the area of the whole wall, find the area of each of these four little pieces that are not getting painted, add them together, and then subtract. Here, boy, this one, I love this problem. This is kind of tricky. A decorative wooden piece is made up of four rectangles as shown. So you've got these four rectangles to the right. And the smallest rectangle, I guess that's this one, it measures, a decorative piece of wood is made up of four rectangles. So I guess this is like a donut hole, right? So this one isn't really there. And the smallest one, that's this one, represents 4.5 by 7.75. And if 2.25 inches are added to each dimension to make the next larger one, so we keep adding in order to get the next larger piece of rectangle. They want to know the area of the entire thing. So I think the first thing we're going to do is we're going to enlarge that picture, and we're going to write in. In fact, let's do it in blue. That this guy right here is 4.5 by 7.75. All right. So now that we know that that's 4.5 and 7.75, and we know that each dimension gets larger by adding 2.25. Let me make sure. 2.25, because it says so right here. You always get bigger by 2.25. So this is where parents and teachers, if you've been doing number talks all along, this doing number talks with fractions is really a good idea, especially in terms of adding halves and quarters, because we want students to be able to add halves and quarters in their head. So we're going to add 4.5, I'm going to write that down, plus 2.25, and that gives us 6.75. So this length right here, and I'm going to do it in, let's do it in red, and let's do it in slightly thicker ink. So that's going to be 6.75. So parents and teachers, you may want to give your students some time to walk through that. And then we need to add 7.75 plus 2.25. And that's how we get the next dimension right here. And 7 3/4 plus 2 1/4, well, 7 2 is 9, and then 3/4 plus 1/4 is 1, so that's 10. So we know the dimensions here, the width is 10. So we've got a height of 6 3/4, we've got a width of 10. Here we've got a height of 4 1/2 and a width of 7 3/4. You know, I use base and height, or I'm never sure about calling it length and width. That never made sense to me, but you get the idea. Now this, I guess this one is the next larger size. So I'm going to take 6 3/4 and I'm going to add 2 1/4. Well, 6 3/4 plus 2 gives me 8 3/4, plus another quarter gives me 9. So this guy is 9. And then adding 10 plus 2 1/4 is pretty straightforward. That gives us 12 1/4. And now we're going to take each one of these and add 2 1/4 to get these new dimensions down here. So 9 plus 2 1/4, well, 9 plus 2 is 11, plus 1/4 is 11 1/4. And then lastly, 12 1/4 plus 2 1/4. Well, 12 plus 2 is 14, plus another quarter is 2/4. That's 1/2. So that's going to be 14 1/2. Or I could call it 2/4 if I wanted to. So there's my dimensions of all of these rectangles. I'm going to zoom out now. And so what's our strategy? Well, our strategy is pretty straightforward, although it's a lot of work. I'm going to call this A, B, C, and D. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to do 4 1/2 times 7 3/4. That gives me A. Then I'm going to do 6 3/4 times 10. That's going to give me B. Then I'm going to do 9 times 12 1/4. And that's going to give me C. And then I'm going to do 11 1/4 times 14 1/2. That's going to give me D. And then I'm going to add all of them up. I'm going to add them together because we want to find the area of the entire piece. And that wraps up a long one. Even though it's just 3 questions, it was a long one. 5th grade, Module 5, Lesson 15, solving real-world problems involving finding the area of rectangles with fractional lengths.